is the story of a tortoise in love. And this is the kissing seat in the little village of Kingston Bagpews in Oxfordshire, where they're famous for doing things slowly. This was the last kiss they had in the village, and the next one was a long time coming. Let's not rush into things. Let me show you around. Let's start with the youngest first. There's young Harry Grandage, just back from boarding school. He lives in the big house. Most normal parents would be there to meet him, but his dad's a banker, and his mother, well, she's being legged over by a banker, just like the rest of us. That fine figure of a man is Albert, the head gardener of Kingston Bagpew's house.
And sir?
He's known Harry since he was a little tax write-off in his father's eye.
Good to have you back.
And this is the big house, Harry's home. In his father's tax return, it's described as office annex. And here we have our tortoise, Tom Coffin, coming home to the village after 3 years in the big city, without a fortune or a wife. And, if we're lucky, he'll demonstrate the legendary ability of the village men to pass up golden opportunities for romance.
So do you like plants?
Yes, I do.
And what else do you like?
Planes?
There's a present on the desk for you, Harry.
Harry loves planes too, and every summer Albert gets him a new one to add to his collection.
Thanks, Albert.
His parents also get him something new every summer. Another au pair. And this year, her name is Anya.
Hello, Harry. Very nice to meet you.
Well, I leave you to get to know one another.
Thank you.
What happened to Beata?
She went back to Poland.
Where are you from?
I'm also from Poland.
Did you know Polish parts were very important in Battle of Britain?
Were they?
Yes, they were. Thank you for all your help.
You're very welcome. You play the violin?
Yeah, we play at school. Sounds horrible.
No.
There was one member of the family that took an interest in Harry, and that was his grandmother.
Morning.
Morning. Kingston House, please.
No problem.
I'm now going to be one of your best customers.
Really? Why's that?
They've just told me I'm not safe to drive anymore. Apparently, I'm losing my marbles.
Oh, dear.
Do you think I'm losing my marbles? To be honest, I may have lost a couple.
Kingston House Tea Rooms is where village news is shared and sometimes completely made up.
Hi, Anya. Have you seen Charlie's new birthday present to herself?
Here they are. They're massive. What did you ask for?
Extra large, of course. My God, you could take someone's eye out with those.
What does it feel like?
Yeah, well, it feels like I'm carrying 2 bags of frozen peas on my chest.
It feels real.
Doesn't it? And also, I've got the undivided attention of every male within 100 miles.
It's undivided attention because your face doesn't get any.
Oh, who cares? All attention. Do you know, the best thing is, I've 0% interest-free credit. I'll pay these off in 3 years.
Here's the boss.
Hello, Harry.
Hi.
And it's a summer holiday, then?
Sort of.
Oh, he's a lovely boy.
Why do English people send their children to boarding schools?
Any rich people do, so they can spend more time with their dogs.
This old Mr. Summers' place. I used to bring people down here for the village fete.
Yes, I'm old Mrs. Summers.
He was a lovely man. Terrible way to go. Wasn't he shot by Mr. Partridge?
Yes. It's what he would have wanted.
Found her!
Did I say that out loud?
Hello, stranger!
see you too, Spud.
Kevin, get that man a drink. I knew you'd be back. What's the big city got to offer that we have? Top women, I'll bet.
Yeah, loads of those.
I bet you didn't get one, though.
Well, it's early days, isn't it?
Well, it's been 3 years. Got a good job, though?
No, I don't, actually. I quit this morning.
What is it you do in Sacmiton?
I'm a microbiologist.
If you're a microbiologist, those other biologists must be massive. What exactly does a microbiologist do?
Well, I know how 987 different types of plants reproduce.
Didn't help you with women, though, did it?
Yeah, thanks.
Cheers!
Hey, Tom, if you're looking for a job, Albert's looking for somebody to help him with his plants.
Jason, Harry's home.
Why? What's the problem?
It's the summer holidays.
You know, the more you pay for school fees, the longer the holidays are. It's a rip-off.
Anyway, he's back. I thought you'd like to know.
Evening, Albert.
All right, Tom. Back in the big city then?
Yeah. I was wondering if,
You pissed away your big career and now you want a job at Kingston House, is that it?
Well, I just thought if you've got
10 o'clock tomorrow morning then. Bring your own mug.
What about the rigorous interview procedure? Morning, Brendan.
Hello, buddy.
Good to see you again. I hear you're starting work as a tea boy.
Done.
You forgot your mug, Tom.
Oh, thank you. So you got a boyfriend in Poland?
No. I used to, but he was no good.
What was wrong with him?
He loved his car more than me.
That's not so bad.
He loved my best friend in his car.
That's not so good.
No.
Don't worry, we'll find you a nice Englishman. All the good ones are taken. Doesn't mean you can't try them. So, what are you looking for?
Well, he must be kind. And he does not have to be rich. He must have a good sense of humour. Nice hands. A good listener. Understands women, you know. Tall. But not too tall. And beautiful hair.
This is the office. Very important. Kettle. This is my mug. Where's yours? Lowest form of life. Maybe I'm going to talk you through the job on it. Tea. Milk. Two sugars. Stir it like you mean it. 1 cup an hour on the hour.
Okay.
Biscuits. Ginger nuts. Custard creams. Ginger nuts are morning biscuits. Custard creams are for the afternoon. 2 normally. 3 when it's raining to boost morale.
If we run out of ginger nuts, can we have custard creams in the morning?
If you run out of ginger nuts, your whole job runs out shortly after. This will be your chair. And now your ear, this will be mine. My goodness, it's time for tea already.
Every village has an idiot, and Spud Collington is an award-winning one.
Who the hell dragged all that mud in here? You can't just walk in here in your muddy boots, you big oaf.
Oh, I love it when you shout at me.
Oh, go round the back.
Morning, girls. Tom Cobham's back.
So we've heard. So, have you noticed anything?
You've had your hair done. Very nice, too.
No.
New top?
You could say that.
I know. You've had your nose done. That was crying out for attention.
Oh, bugger off.
Gotta go see the big man. And this is James, who knows everything there is to know about these things.
They're horses, Albert.
See? I told you, he's an expert.
I know what goes in one end, what comes out the other end. Anything in between, I brush.
Yeah. Who's in the big house? Is Mrs. Summers still here?
She is, but it's owned by her son-in-law, some kind of banker.
Banker?
Total and utter banker. They say he bought the house for 1 year's bonus.
What's my bonus going to be like this year?
Well, it will be biscuit-shaped, and it will taste of ginger. You'll like young Harry. He takes it after old Mr. Summers.
I like Mr. Summers.
No, I like him. Harry, I'd like you to meet Tom. He's our new gardener.
I hear you got some planes up there. Do you mind if I come and have a look?
I'm sure. Come up.
Stuka. Spitfire? What mark is it?
Mark 9. You can tell because the nose is longer.
Ooh, I see that there. Red arrows. Isn't there supposed to be 9 of them?
I'm saving up. My father gives me pocket money, but sometimes he forgets.
Let's kick that into the long grass. Right. Sorry, I was on a call. Grandage? No, I can't help you. I'm not in the help business. How can I help?
It's about the...
Is it the farm? Is everything okay?
Oh, everything's fine there, Mr. Grandage.
Meeting your targets?
So far, so good.
So?
Well, it's about the village fete. We was wondering if you had any ideas for the main event.
What did we have last year?
Dogs.
Let's have horses this year.
We was hoping you might think of something different.
Horses are different. They're not dogs.
But we had horses before, and dogs before that.
Lucinda likes dogs, and she likes horses. Come.
What did he say?
That's a horsey say again, I'm afraid.
Oh, no. They chew up the lawns and crap everywhere.
And the horse is that much better.
Dogs?
Horses. Well, horses making an exhibition of themselves.
Poor dumb animals.
Hello, Tom. How's your new boss?
Great. He's got a relaxed, hands-off style.
It's horses again for the fate this year, Albert. Sorry, I did me best.
Shame. Why is it a shame? I like horses. I'll show you something. This goes back hundreds of years, long before this, before the Norman Conquest, when that William the Coconut came over here with his fancy French ways. Well, what changed? Mr. Randage. That's what changed. He pays the wages, but he doesn't understand how a village works. He doesn't understand the basic principles of how people work. In fact, the only thing he understands is money.
We used to do some fantastic things at the village fete when I was a kid. I remember one year we... What's that beautiful music?
It's Anya.
Anya?
She's my new pet.
Music be the food of love. What's the next line?
What time's tea?
I may have been in Shakespeare's first draft. It's not bad, actually. You have thought about running a couple of plays.
I'm too busy working on my autobiography.
One day, the wind of change blew through the gardens, when Anya said those little words that every man wants to hear.
Hello, Tom. Would you like a cup of tea?
Yes, please.
Sugar?
Sugar.
And I think that was the moment when Tom fell in love. Well, when I say moment, it was longer than that. It was a Kingston Bad Pews moment, which can really drag on.
Are you okay?
I think so.
Okay.
He's still falling there. Believe me, he fell very, very slowly. And that kind of set the pace for things to come.
You haven't moved very far. I'll put it here for you.
Thanks.
You're welcome. I've got to get some sun on my assets.
Surely you can just send them away for servicing.
Uh-huh.
Well then, how are you? Weapons of mass distraction.
See, that's the problem with undivided attention. You get it from idiots as well. Is that an idea? It makes me laugh. Tom, how are you feeling?
Fine. I managed to avoid all the bones in the foot, which isn't bad.
Hey.
Mustache.
That's the slowest dashing I've ever seen.
Is he angry with me about the fog or something?
Judging by his behaviour, he either doesn't like you or he likes you a lot. Mm-hmm.
Nobody in the village really liked Harry's dad. Which was surprising, because he had all the warmth and charm of your average investment banker.
We don't have to have the horses at the village fate. We can have the red arrows.
I've already said horses, so it's going to be horses.
You just saw them.
Who is he?
He's Tom.
Don't ever bring him in here again.
I'm sorry, Tom.
No, Harry. I'm sorry. I really am.
How did it go?
He wasn't entirely positive.
One more thing, Harry. I won't be going to the fete this year, so perhaps you can do the opening ceremony.
What's that, Grandma's?
I think Grandma's.
Grandma is a nutter.
Yep.
Right. Come along, boys. Thank you. It's about the fete, Albert. Mr. Grandage, Jason, is very keen to have horses this year. Sadly, Lucinda will not be taking part this time. The good news is, neither will Mr. Grandage.
I see.
So I'd like to do the fete how we used to do it.
You mean with the village?
With the village for the village.
Well, that's good news. It really is. And you'd like me to...
I'd like you to go to speak to Mr. Partridge. Isn't he the man that shot Grandpa? Oh, it was a mistake anyone could have made. I nearly shot him myself a few times.
Jack Partridge was so ashamed of shooting old Mr. Summers, as you would be, he'd steered clear of the village for years and hidden himself away on his allotment.
Good crop you got there, Jack.
Thank you.
We come about the village fete. Is it dogs or horses this year?
Well, Mr. Grandage says it has to be horses, but he's not actually going to be there this year, so we thought we could do something...
Something like we used to, Jack.
Please, can you help us, Mr. Partridge? Grandma says you're the one with all the good ideas.
What's in here? Horses. Wow. That's a mean-looking beast.
So get in there, Tom. Saddle him up.
Is he dangerous?
I'll say he is.
Whoa.
Step back, everybody!
It's another English tradition. He's just learning to ride. When he passes his test, he gets real good.
Tom! You look lovely.
I...
I think he's speechless.
No, he's just a little horse.
He's got it bad, hasn't he? He can talk to plants, but he can't talk to women. He got a lot more sense out of plants. You fancy coming down the wagon for a pint later, Jack?
Thanks, Albert. But I won't.
Come on, Harry, we've got a horse race to organise.
Hey, Tom, where's your horse?
He's in the stables.
Your face goes funny when you see her.
What are you talking about?
When you see it, it's like your face is melting. That means you're in love.
Rubbish. It means I'm thinking of a very rare plant. Dendrophyllax lendenii.
Why can't you just kiss her?
She can't just kiss people. There's a lot more to it than that.
Like what?
Well, preamble, getting to know each other, background checks, that type of thing. You can't just kiss.
Why not?
Because sometimes it just doesn't work out.
Would you like it out?
Horses is the easy part. It's the jockeys that's tricky. You can't just go asking anybody.
Oh, relax.
This won't work.
It will. Trust me.
So if I understand what you're saying correctly, you want me to run through the streets dressed as a pantomime horse?
Yes, but you keep your dog collar on to maintain your dignity.
Is there a history of mental illness in your family?
Well, he's not going to be a jockey. But he is going to pray for me.
That's a start, I suppose. You know, this didn't work with the vicar.
Uh-huh.
This is not going to work either.
Rubbish. He's a famous actor. He's going to love it. Trust me.
Hello? It's Tom Cobham from the village. I've got an interesting acting opportunity for you. We want you to be a pantomime horse. So it worked then, did it?
Nah, got on his high horse.
Come on. This isn't going to work either.
That's where you're wrong. This one will.
No, this will be your worst. Trust me. Tom, hi.
Thanks for seeing me.
You're welcome. I'm your local MP. My door is always open. Come on in.
Well, what did he say?
He said two words. One of them was off, and the other one wasn't.
We need more MPs like that.
You're asking the wrong sort of person.
Well, I just thought I'd ask people that don't mind performing, you know, actors, politicians.
No, Tom, that's where you're going wrong. What we're doing requires a very special kind of man. They're not your normal celebrities or politicians. They're a breed apart. What you've got to find is men with the strength of character to make total idiots of themselves.
Brendan? Brendan? Brendan, can I have a word about the village fete?
Oh, I should have thought about it. Come on. Come on.
When you're in the army?
Not just the army. The pioneers. Makes the SAS look like the Women's Institute.
It's a dangerous mission.
Count me in.
It involves horses.
I used to train with the cavalry. There's very little I don't know about horses. That's one there.
Oh, you're the perfect man for the job.
Okay, kids, what do you want for tea? Okay, well, I'll have beans on toast.
I want fish fingers.
Well, or we could have fish fingers.
But I want sausages.
Well, or we could have sausages, or fish fingers, or baked beans on toast.
Beans on
toast! Alright, Sean. Give this a good try.
Don't worry about it. I just wanted to get you involved in something. I'll come back.
Because you're little children. Come on.
He's definitely in, but he's not answering.
Well, he just married. What do you expect? Give him a call.
Yes.
What's he say?
Yes. Is he very excited about it?
No, not yet. You should stick to cake. That way you can guarantee satisfaction. Men are like cake. No, seriously, right. Some men are like these ice buns. Great on surface, but underneath, a pretty average bun. Or gingerbread men. They're fun, they're easy to like, but actually, a bit childish.
I went out with a man who was like a caramel fudge cake. Sweet, rich, a little bit thick. Mm. You know, very tempting at first, but you feel slightly sick afterwards.
Mm. Coffee cake for me. It satisfies you in ways men can't possibly imagine.
So, what's your cake?
Well, at home we have a cake called Charlotte, which is very sweet.
I'll come see Bob.
My son.
So, that's the plan. What do you think, Bob? It's a great idea. Let me check with the leader of the opposition.
You think she'll mind?
Of course she'll mind. That's half the fun. I'm so sorry.
Don't worry. There's no use to cry over stuffed milk.
Unless you're a cow.
Let us pray. Forgive us our greed, our impatience, and our general slovenliness. Amen.
I've come to see you about...
Let us pray. Dear Lord, welcome to our table this guest. However unplanned, and unannounced, and uninvited...
And we'd like Mr. Betteridge, Cyril, to be a pantomime horse. Let us pray.
I say that out loud?
Are you getting something together for the village fete?
I'm going to do something with horses. I need a few good men.
You won't find any around here.
I'm always looking for a good man. Hi, Tom!
Tom, would you like a drink?
No, I've got one. Here. Let me get you ladies one.
Oh, thank you, Brendan. Thank you. Cheers.
Sorted. Oh, you crashed and burnt there, mate.
I've got a drink.
You could have got a lot more than that. Why wine?
So, he missed his chance there.
Maybe he plays hard to get.
Men don't play hard to get, because we all know they're not hard to get. I mean, it's easy. All you got to do is look, smile, look away, then look back again. Okay, watch. Count three. See? Come on, have a go.
Do you want a cup of tea?
Yes, please. Milk, two sugars. Hello, Liz.
Oh, don't disturb her. She's on Facebook.
Oh, what's your status?
Just updating it.
Her status is always, I'm on Facebook. If I want to know about her inner emotional life, I have to ask her friends in Australia. Get the milk, Tom.
Divorce list? What's this?
Oh, we've had that since we got married. We write down all our grounds for divorce.
Saves time later.
Doesn't hang up towels.
He thinks towels are self-hanging. You leave them on the floor and they go and hang themselves up.
Doesn't like toast.
I've married the only woman in the world who doesn't like toast. Or eggs. It's a wonder I'm still alive.
Still alive is on my list.
Oh, here's your tea, Tom.
I've got a team together for the village fete this year. And I realised there's one person I haven't asked. You.
Will it make me look foolish?
Yes.
Will I retain my dignity?
Probably not.
Would all the villagers think I'm a complete idiot?
Nothing's going to change there.
Well, count me in.
Testing 3-4. Right. Sorted?
Look at that bird over
there. One of the top three in the village. And she bends over those phone cakes. Oh, you might stick my teeth into her eyes.
Thank you.
job on the fate, buddy. Military precision. Good strategy, well executed. You all right, ladies? You look gorgeous from up here. Couple of nice-looking birds, eh? You should get in there.
I'm not really, Now, what you got to remember is that all is fair in love and war. That's because love and war are very similar. You see, we all love women strategically, but tactically, they are the enemy. You with me so far?
No, I lost you shortly after you started talking.
Look on women as the enemy. A very well-equipped enemy. Take you and Anya.
What do you mean?
Just, for example, if you happen to fancy her. And why not? She's a good-looking gal.
Okay, theoretically.
Theoretically, if you fancied her. Well, you also have weapons of attack. First one and most important, what is it?
Poetry.
Poetry? Do me a favour.
Flowers, I meant flowers. They're beautiful.
No, Tom, flowers are plants. You might as well give her a turnip. You think flowers are beautiful because you're a gardener. I'm a handyman, so I think my hammer is beautiful. But am I going to give it to a woman? No.
So what are my best weapons?
Your key weapon is flattery. With women, you can compliment them on hair, eyes, shoes, or weight. Combining the two doubles the power of the weapon. That haircut makes you look slimmer. Huh? Or that dress brings out the blue in your eyes. See? Hair, eyes, shoes, weight. Bang, 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 bang. They're toast.
Hair, eyes, shoes, weight. Hair, eyes, shoes, weight. Hair, eyes, shoes, weight. Hair, eyes, shoes, weight. Hair, eyes, shoes.
There you are, Harry. Your father wants to see you.
Is it about the horses?
It's about the horses. You can blame me.
You had your hair done?
Yes. Do you like it?
Yeah, it looks good.
Oh, thank you.
Make sure she's the bigger.
Oh.
Harry, your mother and father are getting divorced. Do you know what that means?
Yes, you don't love each other anymore.
Yes, that's right.
And you want to give all your money to lawyers.
We're getting divorced because your mother has chosen to fall in love with someone else. Someone totally unsuitable, it goes without saying. Anyway, the important question is where you want to stay in the holidays. I'm probably going to be on the road a lot.
Or you can stay right here with me in this house.
You're in no fit state.
I still have one or two marbles left. And this is still my house.
This is not your house. I've told you 100 times.
I want to stay here.
Okay, you're here for the time being. Apart from that, this matter shouldn't really affect you.
Does this mean we can have the red eyes at the fate next year?
No, we're having dog obedience trials.
Not dogs again?
Yes, dogs. Real ones. Being obedient like you should be.
That summer seemed to last forever. But then, suddenly, it was time to go.
Have a trip. We'll keep them warm for you.
Things you must remember.
Always do my best and say no to crack cocaine.
Good boy. Now, off you go. The light is waiting.
Goodbye, Harry. Don't do anything I won't do.
You never do anything, Tom.
Yes. Well, that's the way it should be.
Goodbye.
You're in there, mate. Don't move too fast, though. Give it another year or two.
Leave it alone, Brendan.
Well.
I've never seen anyone so miserable.
I think he's bipolar.
No, he's just miserable.
If he's miserable now, wait till he's married.
Tom, if you don't mind me asking, you got
something on your mind?
No, why?
Because that was the tree you were supposed to cut then.
Penultimate question. Who won the 1973 UEFA Cup?
Everyone knows that. Got even dubbing down pop quizzes now.
Don't cheer up. There's more fish in the sea, though.
I don't want to go out with a fish.
Leave him alone. He's given up on women.
Given up? He's hardly started.
Why don't we give you some help, Tom?
Yes.
No, I don't need any help, thanks.
What is the capital of Bolivia?
Bolivia, isn't that something you can't
find? Yes, it is.
I used to do a lot of undercover work in South America.
Hey, Bolivia?
I couldn't tell I was wearing a balaclava.
What do you reckon, Tom?
Sorry? Capital of Bolivia? La Paz?
Keep it down. Right.
Time's up. Pencil's down.
All right, Tom. Any questions you've got about women and how to find one? It's our specialist subject.
All right. What do women really want?
Right, lads. Bonus question. What do women really want? No comparing. Write it down. Billy?
Love.
Oh.
Yeah. Respect. Yes. Intimacy. Romance.
There speaketh the newlywed.
That's what they say they want.
Yeah. But, lads, what do women really want?
Shoes.
Shoes.
Shoes. And occasionally, a damn good...
That winter seemed particularly long. For a long time, Tom was quieter than he'd ever been before. He worked continuously in all weathers. But he was different, working mechanically as if he didn't care. But life went on, as it always does.
Sean! I've got something to tell you!
What's that?
I'm pregnant!
That's fantastic!
Spud, I'm taking the divorce list to the lawyers.
Why?
Because I want a divorce.
Okay, you take the kids, I'll have the cows!
That's disgusting.
Oh, come on, Mum. People don't spend much time under the bar.
They used to in my day. You're obviously not serving them fast enough.
Did I say that out loud?
Tom, there's a letter for you. It's from Poland.
Well, are you going to open it? Come on, Tom. Well?
Yeah, Tom. Blah, blah, blah.
If you don't mind me asking, Bob, when did you and Janet first get together?
You mean how did I win the first prize in the lottery of life?
Yeah.
I'm a bit embarrassed to tell you.
Well, you don't have to.
To be honest, I could never get a word in edgeways, so I left her a note. A big note painted on a banner outside her front door.
What did it say?
Marry me or I'll shoot myself.
Okay.
She didn't respond to that one.
Oh.
So I left another one. You are the most beautiful woman in the world. Go out with me.
And it worked.
Like a dream.
Great.
For my neighbour and a few other blokes. And eventually she narrowed it down to me.
But you've been married years.
Yep. I'll tell you what the secret is.
Bob, get them off.
Always let them think they're in control. Just get them up.
Hi, Spud. I know you're busy, but I've got a quick question for you. How did you get Liz to go out with you?
Same way I get these cows to come into my parlour.
What, you mean you,
Food. That's what brings them in. I sent Liz a giant pizza with I love you, picked out in pepperoni.
That's a great idea. Thanks, bud. There's nothing to this romance business, is there? Doesn't know you're getting divorced then.
Well, I fancied her for ages.
I fancied him for ages.
A bit like you and, Look, Tom, I thought of all of these crazy ideas, but in the end I just said, do you want to go and see a film?
Just like that? I said, do you want to go and see a film?
Yeah, just like that.
What did you see?
Well, it doesn't matter what film it is, because you won't see any of it.
Why not? Right.
Did you study in for it, Tom? At the end of the day, it's all in the lap of the gods.
Funnily enough, inspiration of a sort did come from the heavens. And that inspiration came just when it was needed, at the very beginning of the second summer of love.
Got in here?
French teacher.
Yeah. So, what have you learned since I last saw you?
Scooby-Dooby-Doo, where are you? Upside down in Lazy-Loo.
Useful.
And what have you learned?
Promise not to tell anyone.
Yeah, what is it?
Not a word.
Yes, I promise.
I'm in love with Anya.
Tom's in love with Anya!
We all know that.
They know already.
Anya doesn't.
You can see her tomorrow when she comes back.
Going to. I'm going to write a huge banner saying, "Welcome back, Anya, the most beautiful girl in the world."
In Polish?
Except I don't know any Polish.
What you do is use the computer. It translates it for you. Type in English and there you go. It's in Polish.
Good work. Here she comes, Harry. What does it say?
Webpage currently unavailable. Please try again later.
Women love stuff like that.
And then you can get married.
Well, there are one or two things you have to do first.
Like what?
Today, we've planted the seed. Tomorrow, we feed it.
Hey! Hiya. Did you order pizza?
No.
No, we need it. So I've eaten it. It's weird, right? Pepperoni and chubby parts?
Must be some kind of special promotion or something.
Tastes especially good. Is that your tummy out?
No, I think he's avoiding me. Apart from that crazy banner.
Look, Anya, I mean, you're not making much progress with this. Do you want me to drag him for you?
No, thank you. You're far too busy already.
Ooh! Well, this is enough. If you don't, someone else will. It's quite tasty, you know.
Nice to see you again.
Yes, it is, isn't it? Well, I mustn't keep you.
So you've won first prize already, Susie.
He's getting better.
See that.
Dog obedience trial. I cancelled the dogs months ago, didn't I tell you? I'm sure you'll think of something. Don't worry if you can't.
Is it too late to get them red arrows? We can cut them, they fly really fast.
I think it's probably too late for anything.
I want the red arrows.
But you know, they get booked up years in advance. So, we need another idea. Please.
At the moment, onions are taking up all my creative energy. Leave it with me, gentlemen.
It is quite urgent. It's next weekend.
I'll call you tomorrow morning. 10 o'clock sharp.
So what's been happening with Tom?
I hear he's been chatting you up. He accidentally spoke to her.
I don't know. In Poland, when a guy likes a girl, he talks to her. Takes her out, they kiss. It's very simple. I don't know. English men not like women.
I don't know. I just think most of them would rather clean the car than have an intelligent conversation with us.
I find if you want an intelligent conversation with a man, you have to do most of the talking yourself.
But why don't you just call him? You know, he's too polite to put the phone down on you, then you can just have a chat.
I don't have his number.
I do. You can use mine.
Charlie's got the number of every man in the village. Is my husband in there?
Oh, yeah. He's on speed dial.
Oh, Charlie, leave a message.
He's not answering. Leave a message. Tell him you need help with your buglies.
Hello. Yes. Yes. I've made a few calls, and I was thinking about... That's a great idea. Thank you very much, Mr. Partridge. You're a genius.
Try him again.
Yes, go ahead. We've just been doing some complicated foreplay.
Run, my precious candle, you villain, I'll pass it! Move, I'll pass it!
No!
Oh, cut me in, please. Yeah, guys.
No, still busy. Can I give another time? Okay.
It's rare to find such beauty gathered in one place.
Shame you've spoilt the effect.
Is it, Ida? You know, you ladies, you light up my life.
No.
A brilliant idea. Can you find Anya for me?
Right, got it.
And
And this is his challenge trophy, which... Oh, no. Hold on a moment. Just a moment. We have had an official complaint. Apparently, Mr. Tom Cobham is not a husband and is therefore ineligible for the trials. He has never been a husband, and as far as I can see, there is no prospect of him being a husband.
Oh, that's not true.
Unless, of course, there's someone out there who's prepared to take him. Well, there must be someone who fancies this gorgeous husband.
It's really good this year. It's different.
Well, it's a team effort. Men. Other men. Being women.
I heard that you had many offers from other girls.
Yeah. Yeah. But I didn't get the offer from...
Come quickly. Harry needs you.
Ladies and gentlemen, will you welcome, please, the world foremost, low level, formation flying team.
Chocks away.
You know, we've all forgiven you for shooting Mr. Summers.
Did he say that out loud? For once, he did. Thank goodness.
Or anything. Most of them get a little bee to do their dirty work for them.
Now, stage three. We've planted the idea, we've watered it, we've fed it. Now it's time to take it out.
And bed it.
You're getting a little ahead of yourself there, Harry. This is the difficult part. This is where you could ruin everything.
Anya, he childish poished Zemna Nefim. Anya, he childish poished Zemna Nefim. Hit childish poist, Zemna na film, Anya. Hit childish poist, Zemna na film. Anya. Hit childish poist, Zemna. Do you need some help?
Hey, Anya. Do you fancy going to the pictures with me tomorrow night?
Would be nice.
and she's very tasty.
Jane, the chabbage poi zemna na film. I mean, do you want to go to the cinema?
Yes, I'd love to. Why don't you pick us both up on Friday night at 7?
Foursome, Tom. Could be interesting.
I can't believe I asked the wrong woman out.
You got a date? Is it start? What's the worst that could happen?
It's a total nightmare.
Tom? Harry's got a present for you in the treehouse.
What is it?
I don't know, but he wants you to go now. What are you doing in here?
Harry said there was a present for me.
That's what he said to me, too.
You locked us in. Oh, dear.
Do you want to know what these planes are called?
No. What is that on there?
That's an Airbus 319.
This is Heathrow Airport. This is Airbus 315.
319.
Cleared for landing.
Crash landing.
Do you think Harry's ever going to let us out?
I think he's forgotten all about us.
How are we going to get out?
I thought you were trapped.
Maybe you were.
And that, finally, was the kiss the whole of Kingston Bagpews had been waiting for. There will probably be another one along soon. Well, fairly soon. Thank you.